Hello, so let's continue to talk about this in the question bank of CCIE's core written exam 350 to 401. Regarding the eighth question in the set of 54 practice questions on operational exercises. So when it comes to this question, what we need to consider is actually, it's about a specific topic on BGP within this NP knowledge point. He said that currently R1 and R3 belong to AS1, 2, 3, and R2 belongs to 4, 5, 6. So we need to do it on this side of R2. We will do some configurations within this BGP process. So there are R1, R3, and R2 over here. It's just the two of our sites. R1 and R3 on the left and right are two sites of the same AS. So what kind of accessibility can there be? That means we need to configure between R2, R1, and R3. We need to establish such an EBGP neighbor relationship because we belong to AS456, right? So this question tells you, you are not allowed to modify the configurations of both R1 and R3. We can only pair with R2. The configurations for 1 and 3 have been completed. After you have configured R2 properly, its BGP relationship can be established automatically. Just need to configure R2. So for the last question, he said to make sure this is a root entry with a 32-bit subnet mask. It means our network with a /32 subnet mask. Actually, it's quite simple. R1 has a loopback 0 interface, 1.1.1.1-32. Also, on our side, R3, we have an IP address, 3.3.3.3/32. We need to enable communication between these two sites. These two loopback interfaces can communicate with each other. Once this requirement is completed, we are basically done, right? However, there are actually pitfalls in this question. Actually, this pit is very simple. Our R1 and R3 belong to the same AS, loop prevention mechanism, between our EBGP peers. So if the routing entries being transmitted, among the entries we received, its AS path attribute contains its own IS number, will not be affected by this routing entry. So in this case, we also need to find a way to solve this A loop prevention mechanism between our EBGP peers. There are actually many methods, but we can only configure R2. Actually, among the three methods, we have two options to choose from. There are two methods to solve this question. You can choose two. Let's start doing in the context of the environment. This is our eighth sub-question, R1, R2, R3, our three routers. 1 and 3 have pre-configurations. We have pre-configured the environment. You just need to configure R2 at that time. It does not allow you to modify the configuration of R1 and R3. Look, there's R3 on this side. There is a running config section for router BGP. So there is a configuration. We only need to configure R2. So if you come to R2, first of all, what we definitely need to check is the configuration on our interface here. Is there any issue with our address not being delivered correctly? You see the 00 port is 10.0.0.2. Then for 01, it is 192.168.1.2. Let's first test the direct connection, shall we? First, ping the location. Ping 10.0.0.1. Can ping R1 pass. Then let R2 ping R3 ping to our 192.168.1.3. Test if our direct connections can communicate with each other, then let's configure BGP. We have established a direct connection, our EBGP neighbor relationship. So in terms of router, BGP, we belong to AS456. So the AS number of BGP. When it comes to our BGP router ID, in fact, there are no specific requirements in the question. However, let's manually specify it. Our BGP router ID 2.2.2.2, right? Although not required, we can still equip it. Then we can directly establish the BGP relationship. So R2 and R1. R2 to R3. Let's first establish a connection with R1. Over there is 10.0.0.1, remote AS is 123. Then over there is 192.168.1.3 remote. AS R123 establish a connection with the two of them, our EBGP neighbor relationship. After building good neighborly relations, so as usual, we are definitely able to receive it. R1 and R3 announced to us such a BGP entry. Let's go to show IP BGP summary. So there are BGP relationships, according to what we heard from both of their neighbors. All received an entry from R1, received an entry from R3. So show IP BGP, right? Can detect two routes. Two routing entries have already been added to our BGP table. So next, we need to make sure they are site 1 and site 2. Between site 3, they should be able to communicate with each other. So they need their 32-bit mask entries. Being able to communicate with each other, so everything is above this place, you need to do one more step because you see us from our topic. That's on the R1 side. Received BGP entries with such a AS path attribute of AS123, then R2 advertises this route. When throwing to R3, they both belong to the same AS number. Certainly we'll reject accepting this item. Of course, you can take a look on R3. It has IP BGP. So you can't see our competition site over here. Entry of R1 can't see it, right? So therefore, here we want to solve such an AS path attribute issue with its loop prevention mechanism. So there are two ways. For the first method, it's actually equivalent to not solving. We are sort of taking a shortcut because in the title, just tell them to stand at site 1 and site 2, able to ping each other. Actually, we can have a clever solution. We let R2 here, router BGP 456, right? The first method is relatively simple. Our neighbor is 10.0.0.1. We default originate. Let us unconditionally bow to, let's go to site 1 over there, issue a default route, then neighbor. So 192.168.1.3. Default originate, right? We let the middle R2 separately to R1 and R3 unconditionally send a default route over. In that case, both of them. Although we have not received our counterpart site. For example, take R3 as an example. Entry for 3.3.3.3. Although not, but we can receive it in a while, let our R2. What you have sent to us, this is a default route coming over. Wait for him a moment, just a moment. It will take a bit longer for him to distribute the default route. They should be here, they should be coming soon. Here it comes. So when looking at this side of R1 received from our R2, default route sent to us, so does R3, use IP BGP. So it is. Once the default route is pushed down. For example, you see, now we let R1 ping 3.3.3.3. There is such a route submitted to the routing table. This default route is handed over to R2, then ping 3.3.3.3 source 1.1.1.1. Pass the data packet to R2 will definitely be able to receive BGP configuration on this side of the two sites, their loopback route entries. So there must be routing able to forward packets. Yes, including ours. The same goes for us on R3. So there is a default route can help us access him, the other two sites, so they can communicate with each other. So this is the first method. We let the middle R2 point to our R1 how to distribute the default route on R3. To solve this problem, it is possible. No problem, it is possible because the question didn't specify how we should do it. Of course, this method is relatively, well, that's a bit of a shortcut. It's more of a shortcut. Let's delete this command. We can try a different approach. So, for the second method, actually, it's directly addressing this issue. Issues with BGP route entry propagation. So let's start by canceling this one first, issuing default route. Then let's try a different approach. So the second method is actually very simple. We configure the middle router, R2. Sure, you can. Over there is 10.0.0.1 called AS override. Call override, so let's talk about our R2. We are from AS123. Received such a BGP routing entry, we inform when notifying R1. Among all these BGP route entries within this AS path attribute, such an AS number replace all with your own AS number. This command is quite dangerous, basically rarely used. When we inform the other party of such a thing, when BGP root entries inside this BGP root. So such an AS path attribute, AS number in between override means to overwrite or cover up. Cover with your own AS number on the other side as well. Our 192.168.1.3 AS override, right? So as long as you use this command, and then after going down, you check on R1 and R3 over here. Show IPBGPP, please wait for him a moment. Or just go this way directly. Let's switch gears for a moment. Have you seen your classmates? R1. We have successfully received. This side is for site 2, entry of 3.3.3.3 with a 32-bit mask. Moreover, within this AS path attribute, you see the routing entry itself as path attribute. Came out from AS123, came out through AS456. It should be 123, 1 is 456. But now, when R2 advertises this route, pass the attribute number of this AS path. Everything turned into 456, covered it with its own AS number. Okay, so by doing this operation, you see this side of R3. There will also be a route to 1.1.1.1. There will also be this routing entry. So in this case, students. Now we can go ahead and access it. You can now access it. So let's ping from R1 here, 3.3.3.3, source 1.1.1.1. Ping successful. So this question is done. Choose one of the two methods. Choose one at random. So after doing that, remember we're going to end W2, save the configuration. That's enough. So this is our 8th question. With such an approach, what about the students? If there are any other requirements or want to understand the written test in our, if you have any other questions, feel free to contact us. Welcome to our Wolf Lab. Thank you all. See you later.